Whether you're currently a student or trying to gain new skills through self-study, having a solid study planner can make a huge difference. In this video, I wanted to take you all through how to create a study planner using Notion. We'll be building a basic course or topics, assignments, notes, and task database and combine them into a dashboard. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's dive right in. Let's first start with an empty Notion page, and the first thing I'm going to do is to name this the study planner. After that, I'm going to go to the top right hand corner, three dots, and then turn on small text full width. The next step I'm going to do is to add an icon and a cover photo. For icons, you can use one of Notion's icons here. I'm going to add something like a book here for my study planner. Then I'm going to add a cover photo and change cover, and I like to go to Unsplash for a huge stock image library, or you can use your own pictures. So I'll add something like this that looks like a library. The next thing I'm going to do is plan out the dashboard, and to do that I'm going to have two columns, slash column, and on the left hand side I'm going to add a slash callout box like this so that I can store all of my databases. I'm going to name this databases, and then I will add a bold like this, and inside here I'll start adding my databases. On the right hand side is going to be more like my dashboard setup, so I can see all of my databases in one place. So up here I'm going to have slash heading 3. This one is going to be my courses or topics. So if you're using this for your school, you might want to use courses. If you're using this for self-study, you might want to say topics. And then slash divider. And the rest I'm going to build as we go once I have my databases. So now the next thing I'm going to do is to change this color to default background. This is also up to you how you like to design your dashboards. And now inside here, I can start building out the different databases. So the first thing I'm going to do is to add a courses or topics database. To do that, I'm going to type slash and then database, and I'm going to choose the database full page. And now I'm going to start with an empty database. So this one is going to be called course slash topic. Instead of table view, I'm going to go to the settings here and change the layout into a gallery. And whenever I create my templates, I like to add real information and build around that. So let's say that I have a course for UI slash UX design. Then you can start adding different properties that match with this course or topic. So depending on what you need, you might need a text property that says the room number, and you would put room 102. And then you can also add the dates. So I would put date like this, and then we can rename this to dates, and you could start and then add an end date as well. So say that it ends around here. Another thing you could add would be who your teacher is. So for that, you can add another text property, instructor, and you can really customize this as you need. Once you're happy with all of the properties that you have for your course or topic, what you can do next is to add a cover photo. So I'm going to change cover on Splash. And let's say that I just add this one. And then I can also add an icon if I'd like. Once I have one course or topic in here, I can also go to the settings, go to layout, and I'm going to change the card preview into page cover. I'll also go to the property visibility and showcase the date, instructor, and room. So now I have one course in here, UI UX design, and I have a few properties that I'd like in this course. So now if I go back to my study planner, I can go ahead and add the linked view of this course or topic here. So I'm going to type slash linked view, and I'll add course slash topic and in gallery view, and then I'll hide the database title. So the next database that we're going to build out is going to be the tasks database. For that, I'm going to type slash heading 3, and we'll name this tasks, and then slash divider. And then here I'll have my tasks. So underneath the course and topic database, I'm going to add a new one here, slash database, and I'll choose full page. This time I'm happy with the table view design, so I'm going to keep it this way, and I'll just name it tasks. And again, to do this, I would recommend using real tasks so you know exactly what kind of properties that you need. In this case, I'm going to be adding read syllabus. And I'm going to add a property, and that's going to be, for this one, a checkbox, whether or not I've done it. And also, I'll add a date, so that's the due date, like this. And let's say that this is due on the 14th, and whether or not that's done. For a tasks database, it can be good to see both your completed tasks and your incompleted tasks. So I'm going to go ahead and duplicate this one and call this one complete. And this one is going to be incomplete. And for the complete, I'm going to add a filter, which is whether or not the done is checked. So if it's checked, it's going to go into complete. I'll save for everyone. And now let's say that I've done this one. It's going to go here. And now I have to add another filter here where the done is unchecked. Save for everyone. And I'll actually move the done to the left so that it kind of has this nice checkbox design. Then the next step I'm going to do is now connect my tasks to the course or topic. So to do that, I'm going to add the plus here again and then choose relation. And I want to relate this into the course/topics database. So you'll see that here. And I'm going to add a two-way relation, add relation. So let's say that the read syllabus is for this UI UX design course. Then I have that here. If I go to complete, I also see that now here. So everything is working as intended. Now I can go back to my study planner. And now I'm going to add that database as a linked view database. And I'm going to add that tasks database. I'll have the incomplete view, write this database title. And then I'm also going to add another empty view for the tasks. And I'm going to have the completed view on this side. So now I have my incomplete and complete view. And now if I go to my courses/topics, you'll see the task here in my UI UX design course. I'm going to actually just hide this one so that I don't see it here. And later on, I'll show you how to connect everything into this one course and see all of your tasks for that. Before we get into creating the note-taking database, I wanted to share with you all the sponsor of today's video, which is Slax Note. Are you tired of missing out on spontaneous ideas or struggling to take notes during lectures? Slax Note is an AI-powered voice notes app that will revolutionize how you capture your thoughts. With just one tap, you can record your ideas, and Slax Note's advanced AI instantly transforms your voice into perfectly formatted text. Here's why I recommend Slax Note. You can simply speak what you're thinking and have it transcribe and polish your text. I think that sometimes the fact that you have to type things out can take away from spontaneous note-taking. For example, in this case, you could also use Slax Note and later paste in your notes into Notion. It can really help with boosting your efficiency. Another thing I love about Slax Note is its intelligent ghostwriting with custom prompts. You can use one of the included prompts or create your own Slax Note prompts. The ghostwriting can turn your speech into outlines, Instagram posts, summaries, and even correct your grammar. I've personally enjoyed speaking out my email responses and having it polish it up for me. Ready to transform how you take notes? Download Slax Note today from their website at note.slax.com or find it on the App Store and Google Play. Link is also in the description below. Now let's get back to our tutorial. So next we have our notes database. So for that, I'm going to go ahead and again, click the plus sign here /database and choose full page. And in here, I'm going to call this note. And for notes, let's say that I have notes for first lecture, and I'm going to add the property, which is going to be the relation, and the relation is going to be to the course or topic. And I'll do two-way relation again, and I'll put the UI UX design course. The next thing I'm going to do is change this into the created time, so it's going to automatically timestamp for that for me. I might also add a file and media so that I can attach documents to this as well. And now if I go back to my study planner, I have my notes here. If you'd like, you can also add the notes here as well. So I'm going to do heading 3, call this notes/divider and /linked view of database. And then I'm going to choose the note, the table view, and I'll hide the database title, and I'll also sort it so that the created time and I want it to be descending, say for everyone. So if I were to add a new one, it's going to go to the top like this. So now we have the final one, which is that you might want to keep track of your assignments. So for the assignments database, I'm going to go ahead and again click the plus sign here, slash, and then I'm going to add a database full page, and this one's going to be called assignments. And here, let's say we add a sample assignment. We want to do an essay one and add a property. We're going to add a due date. So I'm going to add a date and we'll call this due date. And then I'm also going to add a done status. So I'm going to go ahead and add that checkbox just like with the tasks. And I'll name this done. I'll also add the files and media here. So now we have a very basic assignments with the due date and the name of the assignment and whether or not it's done. And for this one, it's also good if we have a calendar view. So I'm going to add that in. And I'm going to change the property visibility to show the done status. And if I go back to table, let's say that I add the due date here to the 14th, then my calendar shows essay one, whether or not that's done. The other thing I'm going to add now is the relation to the course or topic. So again, I'm going to relate it to course slash topic, two-way relation, add relation. And let's say that this is for this course. Then if I go to calendar, I can go and to the settings and then property visibility and then show course slash topic like this. So you can see exactly what course this is relating to. The other thing that I've really been enjoying doing with some of Notion's newest features is that you can actually add a conditional color. So when it's done, I like to mark it as green. So if the done is checked, I'm going to change the page background to green. So now if I test it out, you can see it like this. So now I can go back to my study planner and then I'm going to go ahead and slash heading 3 and I'm going to add assignments slash divider and slash linked view. So I'm going to link that view of the assignments here and I'll have table view and I'll hide the database title here and then I'll add a new one. And this one's going to be the assignments again, but this time in calendar view. And we have that here. So we have table and calendar. So now we have all of our basic databases, which is the courses and topics, tasks, notes, and assignments. Now what we can do is change the icons here so that it's a little nicer. So for course and topics, maybe you want this one. For tasks, you might want a check mark. For notes, you could have a paper. And assignments, you can do an exclamation point like this. And now the final step is actually to connect your tasks, notes, assignments all into your courses slash topics database. So we have here our notes. So I'm going to change the property visibility to always hide. I'm also going to always hide the assignments. And now we have a clean slate here. And what I'm going to do is go to the blue button here and click plus new template. So when you have a new course slash topic, this is what it could look like. So I'm going to put slash heading 3. This could be the course description if you'd like. And then we would have a few things here. And then you can add slash heading 3, some important documents. And then let's say that you want to add embeds for those. So you can embed anything you want. Then we can have slash heading 3. Your tasks slash divider. And here I'm going to add the linked view of the database. And we're going to choose the tasks and I'm going to show the incomplete. And I'm going to hide database title. And then I'm going to add another empty view, which is the tasks again, but this time the completed ones. And for these, we're going to add a new filter. So I'm going to click plus filter course slash topics. And I want this to be the new course slash topic. And for this one as well, I'm going to add the filter that it's the new course slash topic, save for everyone. And then the final step is that you can hide this one. So I'm going to click hide and hide because it's going to be the course or topic that we're currently on. The next step is going to be to do that same thing for the notes, slash heading 3. And I'm going to add the notes slash divider And here I'm going to add linked view and choose notes and table view. And then I'm also going to add the filter course/topic, and it's going to be the new course/topic. And also hide the database title and hide this one as well. The third database is going to be the assignments, so /heading 3, and I'm going to call this one assignments /divider/linked view of database. And I'm going to add assignments. I'll have one in table view. I'll add a filter, which is the course/topic is the new course/topic. Hide this one so we don't see it. And then I'll hide the database title and then add a new view, which is going to be that calendar. And I'll also add the filter, which is the course/topic, new course/topic, save for everyone. And then finally, I'll add the property visibility and turn off the course/topic like this, so we only see whether or not it's done. So now we have everything here, the notes, the tasks, important documents, course description. And the good thing about these headings is that you can easily navigate through them with the table of contents. So now we can go back to our UI UX design and then choose new course/topics, and everything is going to show up here. So we have our tasks, we have our notes, we have our assignments here and in the calendar view like this. And if I were to create a new course or topic, it's going to also add that same template in for me. So I can actually set this one as a default for all views. And then let's say that this course is for Spanish. I have my course description, important documents, and then now I don't see any tasks, notes, or assignments because I haven't added anything yet. I could add a new task. Let's say that I also need to read a syllabus for this one. And let's say that I have a new note, first lecture, and then I can also add an assignment. So new essay. And I can add a due date for that. If I click out, you'll see that I have my Spanish here, I have my Spanish here, and everything has been updated accordingly. And for example, if you're actually actively using this and want to take notes, you'd simply have to type the notes inside of here. So you can see there's a whole bunch of space here where you can add your notes. Same for the tasks, you can add extra notes inside. And same for the assignments, you can add extra notes about the assignments inside. So that was the basics of creating your own student planner. I now wanted to just share with you briefly about some of the student planner Notion templates that I have over on my store if you'd like a pre-made solution. This one is the minimal style, and I have a bunch of different styles for this, but the student planner templates have a lot of features. So we have our to-do list, contacts, courses, even grades, resources, and flashcard decks. So I would highly recommend checking it out just to show you some of the other styles that I have over in the store. This one, for example, is in a boho style. This is in a light academia style. And for example, here I have a Ghibli theme inspired version. So if you're a Ghibli fan, you might enjoy this kind of style as well. There's also a mountain theme like this, cottagecore, and a plants theme. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that this was useful. Be sure to check out Slax Note in the description below, as well as the student planner templates if you'd like a pre-made solution. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.